Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic with me, Grey Hunter, where last time I said that I would skip this next bit because I was just going to go sell stuff at Yavin, but I actually forgot. I started recording and then I remembered that there's actually a cutscene right after we leave this planet, so I have to record the journey there. But I won't make you sit through all the selling of stuff, I'll just... yeah. You'll see. So back to Yavin we go. Allons-y! Bye, Kashyyyk. We won't be coming back to you. Forest world. Have a good war, Wookiees. Good luck storming all the castles. Now, it's possible that we'll get intercepted by Sith starfighters as we leave, but I don't think so. I think there's a chance for it to happen. But yeah, cutscene.
Kalonord is dead, Lord Malak. He has failed in his mission. Forgive me.
The penalty for failure is death, Admiral Karrath. But the failure was Kalos, not yours. You may rise.
Shall I hire this another time. Bounty hunter, Lord Malak?
No mere bounty hunter can stand against a Jedi. I shall not make the same mistake again. My apprentice, Darth Bandon, shall take care of our young Jedi friend.
Darth Bandon? You! It's that guy from the beginning of the game. And he's still a big... he's still a big jerk. But then again, you know, he's a Sith, so I guess that's par for the course, isn't it? Darth Bandon? Darth Jerkula?
Find Bastila and bring her to me, alive, if possible.
As you command, Master.
So yeah, Kalonord tried to kill us and failed. This guy's gonna come try and kill us and, well, we're gonna have to kill him too, I'd imagine. But for now, we get to come back to Mr. Rodian's place, and I do need to record up to going to see him for reasons you will see in a moment. There's other people here, you see. And this is a very important part of the game. You wouldn't think so, because Yavin's all the way over here in the, you know, in the middle of nowhere, but for the end game, you can get some pretty cool stuff here. I mean, this guy, he will purchase your stuff for more than anybody else will. And he's got some pretty decent stuff of his own to sell. So it's worth coming back here. If you don't come back here, you don't get access to some really, really, really high tier stuff, which you kind of need. So here we are to make some money and to get access to his special stock. We won't get access to his special stock yet, but we will eventually. For now, hello.
The color of a mesh under the sky.
So they're trying to extort him, it would
seem.
I don't know that the exchange can do much, because I kind of killed the gang boss. Yeah. I'm sorry, Sivam. They have some really weird pauses in this. That's a fair point. So, Suvam, what the hell's going on here? Those bastards. Those bastards. I have altered the deal. So, you know, we can offer to be cut in if they're gonna kill him, but really, that's just... no. And we're a Jedi, we're not just gonna leave him to the wolves. I think you gentlemen better leave. Well, yes, actually. You can't kill them now. They are going to come back later, but you can't actually do anything about them now, so we're just gonna force persuade them to get the hell out. Yeah, off you go. on your bike? So yeah, they're gone for now. Agi inko tune chuna muri ra tangi wama jiko na tong kipa nonku nek abog ki muri ra kun kin. It wouldn't really have made a difference, Sivan. They're coming back. I know, I've played the game before. I know they're coming back. So he doesn't have anything new to say, so I'm just going to cut recording here and come back after I've sold all of our many things so that we have lots of money. Alrighty, so we sold all of the stuff that we didn't want, pretty much everything that wasn't going to be useful to us, and we ended up with, where's our inventory? There it is. We ended up with 24,000 credits and some change. So we're going to need more than that for later, but for now, that's a pretty good deal. So we're going to head back to the ship and talk to some folks, and then we're going to head off to Manan. I'm not going to be talking to everyone, as I said in the previous episode, because not everyone is interesting. Some people are boring as crap. Mission, looking at you. And some people we've already done all the talking to that we need to do, like Karl and Bastila, so really, the only people we're going to be talking to is Canderous. Canderous, HK, maybe Juhani, if I can be asked, and Jolee. So, because we're near the medbay, Jolee, you're up first. Hey, bro.
Got something on your mind, do you?
I do, actually. Why'd you decide to come with me?
Got yourself a fast little ship? I'd forgotten what engine sounded like. The closest thing to that on Kashyyyk is an Ullaran mating season. Frightful.
It doesn't really sound all that nice, no. So you just wanted to ride on the ship, yeah?
Or it could be for the free food. What's the gunk that comes out of the synthesizer on this bucket anyway? Do you never clean the darn thing?
It's not my ship. So, he's quite evasive. If you don't want to answer the question, just say so.
How impatient can one person be? You must have driven your mother mad. All that gurgling and fussing. Babies are cute, but annoying. You know, you remind me of someone else I knew ages ago. Pleasant enough fellow, great destiny, all of that. Breath like a panther.
I see. You're avoiding the question.
So I am. Tell you what, when you get to be my age, you can go ahead and answer any question you like to. You have my permission. Anyway, here.
Gee, thanks.
Oh yes, Andor Vix was his name. The Force swirled around him like a hurricane. That's how great his destiny was.
And you traveled with him, I imagine?
I did. Just because someone has the Force swirling about them doesn't always mean they have a great destiny. But it doesn't hurt to check it out. Well, it turned out that poor Andor believed a wee bit too much in the infallibility of that destiny. That overconfidence turned out to be his downfall.
So, yeah, I like the conversations with Jolee. There's some bits where you just kind of... You get that the idea is he just wants to tell you a story and for you to take the lesson from it that you will. And some of the responses for this are just like, really? I guess I'm going to go with the first one.
I don't know. Are you overconfident?
See?
I hadn't noticed.
Lessons.
Even if I had, I would never comment on it. We're talking about Andor, remember?
Let's see.
Oh yes, Andor's downfall. I was pretty young myself when it happened. At the time, I thought that Andor's destiny couldn't be more boring.
How young are we talking?
Well, let's just say that I was a strapping young lad with a full head of hair, and Coruscant was a small town with a will. I was just about to abandon Andor to whatever the Force intended for him when his ship was overtaken by a Dimian warship. Now, you've probably never heard of the Dimians. But at the time, they were a nasty lot led by a nastier overlord named Krat. Tall fellow, big teeth. Krat has us hauled onto the bridge of his ship for questioning. And that's when I knew that Andor's destiny was at hand.
How did you know?
Swirling Force, remember? Jedi here.
Right, of course.
Granted, I was just interpreting the signs, but we get trained in that sort of thing, more or less.
I didn't.
Well, Andor decides that his destiny makes him invulnerable and starts making all sorts of demands. Free me now. I'm not answering questions. Blah, blah, blah. Don't you know who I am? Krat decides he's had enough and begins crushing Andor's neck. I told the boy he should have kept his mouth shut. I think he agreed, too. Or sounds could have just been gurgling noises. Well, anyway. Finally, Grant has enough of Andor and tosses him aside into this giant energy intake shaft. Andor gets sucked in and starts bouncing around, screaming. Maybe Andor hit something sensitive on the way down or just didn't agree with the reactor core. Next thing I know, all the ship's alarms are ringing.
So the great destiny is basically, he fell down an energy intake shaft. Great.
Everyone panics and I run, barely making it to the ship in time before the explosion. Krat dies horribly, and the Dimians never quite recovered. Changed the political course of the entire sector for centuries to come. I'd call that quite a destiny, wouldn't you?
For centuries to come implies that he's pretty old. But he never says how old he is. I am curious. I hate you all.
Well, now that's the ingratitude of youth for you. I relate an exciting tale, and do I get thanked for it? No. No. It's all me, me, me. Anyway, go on. My throat is dry, and you're making me cranky. Shoo.
Thanks, Jolee. Cranky old man. Alright, so, next up on the list of people to go see is Canderous, because his is pretty short.
Yeah, what do you want?
Well, I was wondering if you had any war stories, bro.
I was one of the best youth warriors in the Clan Ordo in my time. No one before me had mastered the power of our basilisk war droids as quickly as I had. Except Mandalore himself, of course. In those days,
naturally,
we were sweeping across the Outer Rim, destroying all who fought us. Young Mandalores would prove themselves in real combat with unknown opponents above 1,000 worlds. Each brought back stories of his achievements.
Interesting. What was your story?
I remember it well, orbiting high above a placid world, its defenses just stirring. As was tradition, I would go ahead of the first wave to find enemies in the thickest fighting. I remember sitting there in my armor, linked directly with a basilisk thrumming beneath me. My heart racing with fear of the coming battle.
Indeed. And what happened next?
The doors opened in front of me, and the air was sucked out of the drop bay, scattering crystals of frozen vapor across my path. I can't describe what it feels like to look directly down at a world, falling continuously as you circle it, with barely 15 centimeters of armor plate protecting you. When the magnetic locks disengaged on my droid, I plunged out of the drop bay towards the battle that waited below.
So you rode into battle on a droid.
The exhilaration, the euphoria I felt as I streaked into the atmosphere, dodging self-guided projectiles and beam weapons, was unmatched. An 80-kilometer plunge through the atmosphere, dodging and weaving, the outside of my armor glowing like the sun with the heat of re-entry. And with barely 30 meters to spare, I twisted and skimmed the surface, firing at the giant beam generators that were in my path. The explosion from that sent shock waves that leveled the entire complex around it. It was the moment of my life.
So these droids, how would one acquire a basilisk? If one was so inclined, not that I want one or anything, I want one.
I'll never forget those times. But things are different now. We can't go on fighting the way we did. There are too few of us left now. But I really don't want to talk about this anymore.
I can't get one.
I trust I've satisfied your curiosity for now. Is there something else you want to know?
No,
I'm good. Your choice. I'm here if you want something done right.
I know, Canderous, I know. It's cool. I will come back to you immediately if there's something I want done right. Now, I do want to go to these and... Which one of these is better? Damage bonus plus 4. Yeah. Alright, Missions Vibra Blade's getting stripped. And Baka's Ceremonial Blade, which is very, very, very good, is getting those upgrades. So when Karl comes back to being on the team for one mission, he's gonna get Baka's Ceremonial Blade. Alright, and armor. Have I upgraded this yet? Yes, I did. Okay. And I don't think there was anything else I want to put on my lightsabers. We're all good. I sold one of the double-bladed ones because Suvram Tam buys them for 780 something. Everybody else only buys them for about 300, so it was worth selling one to him. Alright, HK-47. My homie. My favorite droid in the whole wide world.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
Well, I'm glad. I would like to know more about your functionality.
Statement. I know some elements of my functionality, Master, but not all.
Oh? How is this possible? I thought you said that removing the restraining bolt would make it so you remembered things.
Qualification. I suspected that it might, Master, but without memory, I had no way of knowing whether or not I knew that was true.
So you lied.
Qualification. Not so much, Master. I spoke out of ignorance. I assumed the Athorian was responsible for my memory loss.
That I guess
that
makes
sense.
Does
not mean I am not a fully loyal droid willing to serve its master. Right, Master?
Of course. But how can you not know parts of your functionality?
Answer.
How is this
there
true?
Have been numerous repairs and tampering made to my system, Master. Several systems are not operating as they should be. The fact that my memory is incomplete may be due to meatbag incompetence, or something else I am unaware of.
And this is why I took lots of repair skill. You can fix him up. Doing the third planet, an event will happen after that. The game is old, but I'm imagining that there are actually some people watching this who haven't played it before, so I'm trying not to ruin the plot. An event happens after the third planet in which he manages to recover his memories, but you can fix him so he recovers them quicker, and he gets a bonus to stuff and things if you decide to bring him along, so like skills and such. So let's try and repair him.
Answer. Some of my motor functions can be safely repaired, Master, but anything in relation to my memory core is extremely sensitive. I have safeguards installed to protect that core that I cannot deactivate. It is not impossible that other, lesser memory functions could be restored, however.
So I can restore bits of your memory?
Answer. You may attempt to restore portions of my deleted memory, Master, but some skill at repair is required. The deeper functions of my core memory, however, would still be unadvisable to tamper with. Conjecture. It is possible that some external stimulus might result in the memory core being reactivated, but I am unaware of any program existence to do so.
So basically you're saying that your memory might just come back.
Conjecture. There may be hidden programming that awaits certain conditions to reactivate my memory core, Master, but there is no way to know. It is quite possible that tampering has simply erased my core permanently. If that is so, a meatbag will surely pay.
Alright, so how do I go about fixing you?
Answer. Simply tell me that you wish to make the attempt, Master, and I will attempt to walk you through it. Please do be careful.
Well, I'd like to try that.
Affirmative. If you believe your skills are up to the task, Master, then I can certainly guide you through the process. Request. I only ask that you be oh so very careful, Master. I am too valuable and well-crafted to perish at the hands of ineptitude.
Are you calling me inept? See there, haha. Are you saying that I can't do my job?
Negatory. No, Master. You are not a droid, however, and therefore your skills are limited by the physical capabilities of your meatbag extremities, or some such.
I love how you can be so defensive about it. I happen to be very good about at what I do.
Appeasement.
I will have
yes,
you know.
Yes, Master. Of course, Master. Could we begin?
Stop appeasing me, dammit.
Statement. As you wish, Master. The first stage is the simple one, and that is accessing my central control cluster. This may take a while. First, you will need to open three panels.
I'll skip these bits of the dialogue.
And now rewire the last three relays. Yes, good. Well done, Master. I believe your operation was a success. Accessing new memory. Access complete. I have restored a great deal of information about my previous owner, Master. Would you like to hear it?
Sure. Tell me all about them.
Recitation. The earliest memory of my last owner specifies that he was human, a low-ranking commercial officer for SizeTech Corporation. I am unaware of his designation. He purchased me from an acquaintance I cannot identify for the purposes of protocol and bodyguard duties.
Sounds right up your alley. But why can't you identify who sold you to him?
Explanation. That previous owner is part of memories that are still deleted, Master. It is customary for droids' memories to be wiped when it is sold.
Of course, of course. So this man that we're talking about, is he alive?
Answer: negative, Master. The human was terminated by this HK-47 unit prior to system shutdown.
I see. You killed him?
Affirmative, Master. Though well, I had not been programmed to do so. The human's termination was accidental. Explanation: my former master had owned me for a duration of 2 standard months before discovering my assassination protocol. He was pleased by the discovery. The human informed me that a competitor corporation was preparing to market a product that would ruin him personally. He was most agitated. He activated my assassination protocol and instructed me to kill all those responsible for the competing product. I proceeded to carry out my order.
Okay, I'm understanding so far that you went out and killed his enemies, but why did you kill him?
My former master was unaware of this, but the competitor was in fact an arm of SizeTech Corporation, my master's own employer. It did not take long for my master to realize his mistake. By then, I had already terminated 104 corporate officers.
That's pretty good. You killed 104 people. That's a pretty good start. So he set you upon his own company. How did he not know?
Observation: while it may have been unintentional, my master's wording of his orders left little room for me. SizeTech was responsible for the product, after all.
That's true.
I do not know why my master was so upset, really. He was an officer of SizeTech and a potential target, but I cannot terminate my own master. I would assume that being the sole officer remaining, he would surely be promoted. Instead, however, the human chose to go insane with rage and attack me.
I see. And that's when you killed
him. Objection? Naturally not, Master. As I said, I am incapable of purposefully terminating my owner. That would not be allowed. My master was not a smart man, however. While he was screaming and stabbing me with a writing utensil, he managed to pierce one of my actuators. The resulting shock terminated him and sadly destroyed my assassination protocol. Pure luck on his part, I suspect.
Yeah, he's kind of dead, though. I don't think he's quite as lucky as you think he is.
Query: do you know what the chances are of puncturing that sole actuator? I would have congratulated my master were he not sizzling and incoherent at the time. I shut down immediately whenever my master
died.
By
that logic.
I can only assume that while I was shut down, SizeTech was dismantled and I was auctioned off as former corporate property. Observation: no doubt my sale price was quite cheap, leading to Yukalaka's purchase. How very demeaning.
I love his voice acting. It's so brilliantly monotone and robotic, yet full of emotion. It's great. But how did they not know? Well, I guess it kind of makes sense that they might not.
How could they?
Yeah.
The vast majority of the officers had already been terminated. They likely assumed I was mere chattel.
That's true. Did you recover any other memories?
I have recovered knowledge of some other actuators which will enhance my performance, Master. I will activate them now. But as for my own history, negative. It will require further effort on your part to restore them, if you wish. Though certain stimuli could always restore my core still, as I explained. For now, please excuse me, Master. I wish to meditate upon the face of my former meatbag master as he was electrocuted. I find it most soothing.
You're a very disturbing robot, HK-47. So you gain some extra dexterity, which is cool, but we actually have enough skill to do all of the repairs. So we're gonna go back in.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
Yes, indeed. I would like to try and restore some of your...
Affirmative. Request.
I do. Yes, I know.
Statement.
Let's get started.
As you...
And as I said, I will skip
and
this dialogue.
And now rewire the lab. Access complete. I have recovered information on my owner previous to the commercial officer, Master. Intriguing.
And who was this person? What's so intriguing?
Statement. It appears that my previous owner was a human senator on the planet Coruscant, a man of importance who obviously appreciated quality craftsmanship.
And how did he get a hold of you?
Answer: I am unsure, Master. Any knowledge of my owner prior to him is still deleted. The senator did assume I was a protocol droid, however. I do remember that I was very pleased to be the property of a senator. One of his assistants discovered my assassination functions later through questioning. The assistant was quite alarmed and told the senator I should be scrapped quickly to avoid a scandal. Naturally, the senator had me eliminate the fool.
Oh, naturally. Of course. We're not talking about a nice senator, then.
Observation. Senators are not nice, Master. They are either on top of the game or yesterday's news. My master told me that frequently, you see. I was most proud to have partaken in the political system of the galaxy. During the time my owner possessed me, he gained significant rank. Given time, I believe he could have become Chancellor. I even eliminated a few key opponents that he did not ask for. Freebies, if you will.
Oh, HK-47, how I love thee. You can just kill people?
Answer. Certainly. Why not? I am an intelligent droid, you know. I see an opportunity, and I take it. And my master was most pleased with my work.
I'd imagine he would be, yes.
I think he would have done far better had he not allowed his use of me to become personal. He set me on his wife.
Oh dear. Why did he do that?
Answer. I am unsure. The human was most agitated and angry. I believe his wife had done something that had displeased him greatly. I was to go to their summer estate and terminate his wife, along with whatever male companion I discovered there.
Oh. And did you?
I journeyed to the southern continent, but it appeared my master was not far behind me. Apparently, he regretted his activation of the protocol. When I found the wife and her companion, I proceeded to launch my attack, but my master interposed his own body and was destroyed. It was
so you killed
a
him too.
Meatbag thing to do you not agree? Naturally, I shut myself down, my master being terminated.
Yes, so that's 2 out of 2 masters killed so far.
Observation. Only so far, Master. There are still
that's
more
true.
Memories not recovered, remember?
Right. And what happened to you then?
Statement. I believe the senator's wife was unsure what I was or what to do with me. It was she who sold me to the corporate officer, an acquaintance.
Right. But have you recovered any more memories? I'm interested in that.
Answer. As previously, I have found a few more programs which will enhance my performance. A most gratifying discovery, in fact. There is still nothing from previous memories uncovered. You will have to operate again if you desire to find them. With luck, I will discover the stimulus to unlock my core, and all this will be unnecessary. I do thank you for the attempt, however, Master.
Oh, you're welcome. And I believe there is one more Master to find out about, so
statement.
Let's go back in.
HK4.
Yes, I know all of this stuff. Let's get started.
And now, access complete. I have accessed information on my owner prior to the Senator, Master. Most unexpected.
Why? What have you done?
Answer. It appears that previous to my ownership by the Senator, I was the property of one Bochaba the Hutt on the planet Slaheron.
I see. So you were a gangster's assassin droid.
Statement. So it appears, Master. A rather suitable occupation, would you not agree?
Yeah.
My memories tell me that, for a time, Bochaba was one of the most feared gangsters on Slaheron. I helped him with this reputation greatly. Over a span of 1 year, I terminated a grand total of 322 sentient meatbags. These contracts made Bochaba very wealthy.
That's a lot. And so, why did that stop?
It was unfortunate but inevitable that eventually Bochaba would overstep his bounds. Oh. I had just cleared 2 Hutt households when the exchange retaliated. Statement. I was not even present when my old master was assassinated. I did appreciate the artistry behind his demise upon my return, however.
It was artistic? How so?
Answer. Allow me to say that I have little doubt that residents of that sector were fishing pieces of Bochaba out of their soup for weeks afterward. At any rate,
that's
I
a very bad
shut
mental
down
image.
Upon my master's death. The rival hut claimed me along with my master's other possessions. Observation.
And then sold you, obviously.
If that hut had only known my true function, he surely would not have sold me to a senator he bribed regularly.
You would have preferred to stay there?
Observation. It would have suited my character, Master. I have enjoyed my existence since,
that's true.
More or less. So, I do not miss it.
Do you remember anything else?
Answer. Negative, Master. There is still more memory that can be restored, however, if you wish to try. As well, I believe I can restore several programs the Hutt installed to improve my performance. Yes, they are now active, contemplative. I wonder how many more dead masters I might have out there. A droid can live for a long time, you know.
That's not comforting. I just want you to know that. I thought there was only three, but
statement.
Maybe there is another one. Let's have a quick look. I just might not have enough skill.
Rewire
oh, no.
The last
apparently
three
I do.
Relays. Access complete. I have recovered the last
my
deleted memory, Master. Unfortunately, my history is still not complete.
That's depressing. Why not?
Answer. As I did inform you, Master, the majority of my memory is still locked within my core.
That bit.
That can only be accessed by the appropriate stimuli. And I have no idea what that stimuli might be, unfortunately. Sadly, it seems my true origins will always be a mystery.
That is a little depressing. So tell me about this last guy.
Correction. That would actually be my first owner, Master.
Yes,
the first,
but the last we're talking
I
about.
I can remember. I had completed an assassination in Mandalorian space, though I have no knowledge of what my target was or who sent me. Regardless, my motor function had been damaged, and I could not return to wherever I had been sent from. A Mandalorian soldier claimed me as booty, I believe. He repaired me, poorly, I might add, and proceeded to use my assassination protocol to raise his rank.
Interesting. Did... Is there any way we can find out who sent you there?
Answer. Such knowledge is locked within my core, Master, as I said. There is no way to withdraw it otherwise. At any rate, it seems that my Mandalorian owner finally decided to send me against Mandalore himself.
Oh, this will go well.
My poorest performance, sadly.
Why?
Answer. I was captured by this Mandalore during the attempt. He was able to reverse my programming and send me after my own master.
Clever Mandalorian.
There was little I could do. Needless to say, I dispatched the Mandalorian soldier efficiently. Once I deactivated, I believe I eventually ended up on the black market and was sold to the Hutt on Slaheron. My darkest day.
So you actually did kill that one?
Statement. So I did. I am not very proud of that, Master. The soldier seemed very startled, I must say.
I think I would be too. But there's nothing else you remember at all?
Answer. There are a few Mandalorian implants that I can activate now. They will improve my performance. Beyond
Good.
That, Master, there is nothing more I can relate to you. With luck, we will discover the stimulus to unlock my core very soon.
Perhaps. So he regenerates 1 point of vitality every 3 seconds and has gained an extra +2 to his dexterity. Not bad. Alright, so, that talky-talky session went for a fair while, so I think I'll break the episode here and I'll mark it so people who aren't interested in the background can just skip it, and next time we'll be heading to Manan. So I shall see you in the next video.